So I'm going to use these tomahawks to beat the shit out of Yamato Man. It's going to be fun. What the fuck is Yamato Man? I don't know. I've been meaning to look that shit up, but I never did. Something. Probably a spear man or something, I don't know. So that's all he does is shoot spears. See, the rush module, the jet module is really cool. That's interesting. But this power module, it's mostly just gimmicky. They just put those blocks there for no reason. Which I guess is better than putting, you know, unbreakable blocks there that have to be destroyed with a particular special weapon instead. But, whatever. I don't know. Let's pull this out. Yay! What about special weapons? Just fucking obliterate mini bosses. Otherwise, this playthrough would take 20 minutes longer. Okay, that's the problem I have. One of the problems I have with this inventory system that they broke is that every time you want to use a rush module, you have to sit there and watch the cutscene. Now, you can hammer on the start button to, you know, bypass it, but it still takes another second or two longer than it should, which maybe I'm nitpicking, but it bothers me. After you've seen it the first time, how many times do you reasonably need to see it? You know what I mean? Just a little oversight. I don't know if they were paying attention. Maybe they didn't care. But of course they care. This game is awesome, and it was the last. They figured it was the last game they were gonna make. So, I mean, look at this. This is some genius enemy placement. We're like, I got nothing. There's no way that I can climb up there and shoot him without getting hit in the face. So I gotta use my ingenuity and other special weapons. Which I guess thing. I don't remember the other path because I never take it. I always take this path. But this is the alternate path. So this is where you go to get the beat parts. I assume the other path is harder, but maybe not as well designed. I don't know. Time to pull out the tomahawks. But you see how much trouble I'm having fucking just maneuvering through the menus? It shouldn't be that difficult. It's because you always get stuck on something on the top or something on the bottom. I always get hovering between the E-tanks and the power mod, the rush modules. And it infuriates me. Because it's way more clicks than it should take. It's almost worse than having to deal with Mega Man 3's inventory system with the two pages that you can't read because it only just has initials. And that was Yamato Man. Pretty easy boss. He's kind of more bark than he is bite, but some people say he's kind of hard because he's relentless with his assault. There's spears everywhere. And this weapon's pretty useless. It's sort of like a replacement for the Buster, but I don't find it very useful. At least not compared to much stronger weapons like the Fire Blast, or the Tomahawks, or this guy's weapon, I guess it's a mace. Which, by the way, Nightman is one of the best designs on here. He's pretty cool. He is one of the guys that was designed by an American. So, just a little useless trivia there for you. Pull out my Fire Blast again. Which, the thing I love about this is this game has a great selection of special weapons. Probably the best. Because all the special weapons are different than the regular blaster. Except for, I guess, the Yamato Spear. All of them are way different. So, but they're mostly in the, like, you know, the way they move. So, you have them, and you can use them for situations where your regular Buster isn't very useful because, you know, you're kind of handicapped. You can only shoot in one direction. So if everything isn't lined up perfectly at your shoulder height, then you're kind of screwed. Unless you want to take damage putting yourself in the right position. But luckily, you have a whole roster of all these special weapons that work on all these different trajectories. It's like this one has like an arc, which is more useful than you'd think it would be. I mean, I didn't need to use them on all those guys inside the barrels, but there's a lot of enemies that are placed in this game that are just too low for you to be able to reach, and you can't get down to hit them. So, sort of like that, but not quite more annoying than that. You'll see what I'm talking about, or you probably already saw what I was talking about earlier. Here's another E-Tank I'm gonna get that I'm not gonna use. But yeah, you may be asking, you know, these rush modules seem pretty cool. Why don't you use them all the time? Well, two reasons. One, you can't charge your shot, which you can get around that. It's not that big of a deal. But the biggest deal is you can't do a slide. And that's a big deal. Also, I'm not sure if this is true or not. It seems to me when I play with the modules that when I jump, I can't rapid fire jump like I can when I'm not wearing a module. At least it seems that way to me. It seems like there's a small delay when I hit the ground because of all the extra added weight. So Nightman. Nightman is completely impervious unless you hit him from behind. Unless you're using the Yamato Spear, which is why it's his weakness. Does a fuck ton of damage, just jumps around, shoving his ball in your face, and he's none the wiser. Because as we all know from playing medieval games and I don't know, I guess RTSs, that a spearman beats a swordsman all the time. At least I think so. I could be way off. This is kind of misleading, but that mace doesn't just go off into infinity. It kind of loops around, sort of like Quickman's boomerang, but it's way stronger than Quickman's boomerang. Just not as fast. So Centaur Man, I thought was kind of a weird choice for a boss. I think it's the weirdest one. He's basically like Flash Man, except much faster. And not as cheap. Because Flash Man was like, oh, you can hardly move around a screen without running into me because, you know, you can hardly move at all as it is. And I'm going to freeze you in place like every 5 seconds. And you're gonna have to deal with me. But this guy is just like, he just runs around, he teleports. All kinds of good stuff. So this is our token underwater level that everyone hates, especially me, where you have to deal with alternate gravity and instant death spikes if you hold the button for a tenth of a second longer than you need to, or a tenth of a second shorter than you need to. Which almost killed myself right there. So, to me, trying to beat all these games that I've beaten like 100 times, I still get fucking paranoid and anxious whenever I play levels like this one. And there's always one in every Mega Man game, and I hate them, because when I die, I don't feel like, oh, I fucked up. I feel like, why did you design it this way? It's bullshit. It's not challenging. It's just fucking... I don't know. Maybe it's me. Maybe I'm missing the point. But I think if Mega Man was missing just those parts, where it's like instant death spikes, then yeah, I would be happier. And it's not like I'm against pits either. Like, I like pits, open pits. It's a common trope. I can deal with that. You know, jumping over an obstacle. But, yeah, it's basically like every time you play a level like this in Mega Man, you're on Ninja Warrior. You have to do it just perfectly. And if you lose your balance for a second, you gotta fucking come back next year and try again. And next year, the competition's gonna be even harder. Assuming anybody that's watching this shit knows what the fuck Ninja Warrior is. Now, I'm not doing too good of a job here, but I could definitely kill this squid much faster if I was using a weapon. But I'm lazy and stupid, sometimes I forget that this is a speedrun. here we go. This is another alternate path where you can jump down there and go. There's another exit right there, which not much of an alternate path. But if you want to get the beat parts, you got to do it this way. It's not as time to beat a dead horse or beat a horse till it's dead. Something like that. I do kind of like his design, though, because he kind of reminds me of Gyro Man, except in a horse. So I don't know what's going on with this guy. Yeah. Not so bad when you have their special weapons. Which, again, I love the way they designed it in this game, where basically, this game takes everything Mega Man 5 had and makes it way better. It kind of takes the best of 5 and the best of 4, in theory, and puts it together with some new stuff, like the Rush modules. Because, like, the bosses of Mega Man 4 were really hard, but if you had their special weapon, usually you made it way easy, because it would either do a sick amount of damage or it would completely cripple them. And in 5, the bosses were really easy, so if you just had a special weapon, you'd just be able to kill them faster, but it wouldn't make them any easier, because they were already stupid easy. Now, just so you know, I don't condone panda violence, but these pandas are shooting me with lasers and rocks, so they really give me no choice. If it's between me and a panda, I'm not letting that panda live. I'm just saying, he threatened my life. So let's see. Climbing ladders. Now this level really pissed me off first couple of times I tried beating it. Because this is sort of like Plant Man stage. Combination of Plant Man stage and Centaur Man stage. Where they have all these fans everywhere that are supposed to, you know, push you up so that you can get to the next platform. But they're not reliable. The physics in this game are kind of weird. You don't know what the fuck's going on. So, if you try to jump on these fans, then sometimes you'll just hit an instant death spike and that'll be it. Game over. Or, you know, you'll think that, hey, I'm at the top of my jump. The fan blew me all the way up in the air. I can just go and I can make the jump. And then, no, you fall right off the side, just barely missing it, and you die. So, that's why I get the jet. That's why I don't do this stage first, even though this guy is really easy. I go get the jet first, so I can make sure I can bypass all that stupid bullshit. I don't know if it's different than the way that beat used to work in Mega Man 5, but in this one, he just kind of hits a guy, and he dies. And depending on how much damage it took to kill him, he just takes that much energy. So you don't have to wait for him to hit him multiple times or anything, which is cool. I mean, I'm hardly ever going to use him anyway. But it's nice. It's a nice thing to have every now and then, just in case. You know? I kind of have to make excuses for myself to use it. But, could be damn useful if you're willing to give it a shot. So this is the stupidest part. If you do it wrong, that fan will just blow you all up into death. Nothing you can do. And it's right at the end, so you'd be like, oh fuck, I gotta do the whole stage over again when I was that close, just so I can get back and fuck up again. So this guy fights a lot like Gyro Man from Mega Man 5. Except faster, more in your face. He doesn't disappear. And he's weak to the same move. Fucking flash attack. Also, he has a little bit of Dustman's arsenal. Because he wants to give you a big man hug. Which, by the way, the other guy that was designed by an American player, that was Windman. So, two guys designed by Americans, Windman and Nightman. Pretty nice job, Americans. Now I get the gray color. It is pretty awesome. It's always awesome. except when the weapon sucks, which it always does.